Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Fork Union Military Academy's 125th commencement exercises. I'm Coach Brown, and I will be your master of ceremony. Before we begin, we ask that you silence your cell phones. Our campus is a non-smoking area. Please be courteous and respect others while taking photographs. Graduation portraits are courtesy of Life Touch. We ask that all applause is held until after every diploma has been presented. On our platform, we are joined by our academic dean, Colonel D. Michael Goad, Chaplain Ben Jamison, Academy President, Colonel David Lee Coggins, Chair of the Board, Mrs. Paige Pruitt, our Commandant of Cadets, Lieutenant Colonel Tony Moss, and ladies and gentlemen, our commencement speaker today, Colonel Bill Hitchcock. Ladies and gentlemen, we ask that you please stand for the processional. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise as we pay tribute to this great nation with the playing of our national anthem.
Please take your seats. Welcome to Fork Union Military Academy. I'm Colonel David Coggins, United States Marine Corps, retired the 11th President of the Academy. It's my pleasure to declare the 125th commencement exercise at Fork Union Military Academy to be convened. Our mission is and remains to college prep boarding military style environment in order to instill respect, integrity, faith, character, and discipline in their body, mind, and spirit with a biblical worldview. For some context about our graduates, we have 48 young men today who will graduate. They're from 9 different, and 4 of them are from overseas, representing Mongolia, Taiwan, Vietnam, and Kazakhstan. Some have been here since 7th grade, and some have been here for just a year. There are no easy days at FUMA, 170 academic plus days. That's 344 missions a day, or total. For accountability, personnel inspections, rifle inspections, marching, drill, colors, we salute the flag. Physical fitness, sports club, service projects, field trips, tough academics, and mandatory study hall every night. Everything is assessed, everything is measured to a high standard, an honor code, strict behavior standards, and unbending discipline. They will graduate because they earned it. We're graduating 4 cadets who have been accepted to U.S. Military Academy, United States Naval Academy, and the Merchant Marine Academy. We have 7 who will attend college through ROTC programs, the Citadel, VMI, and Norwich, through our articulation agreement with them. One of our cadets received a $10,000 bonus. He will join the Navy and go to sea. And one is pending in the next few days to find out if he's accepted to the United States Air Force. You do the math on that, that's 25% of our graduating class are volunteering to serve our country. I want them to stand and be recognized. Thank you. God bless you and keep you as you go doing your duty. We are the land of the free because of the brave, and that's you. Our academic program includes many teachers with advanced degrees and PhDs, and one is a Navy captain, retired fighter pilot, and a Top Gun. They teach tough classes, including honors, AP, and dual enrollment with PVCC. Several cadets will begin college this fall as rising juniors, having earned 2 years via the dual enrollment program, thereby saving themselves time and their parents a considerable amount of money. Our college placement career counseling service office is superb. They won awards, and as a measure of effectiveness, a key performance indicator, 100% of our postgraduates and college seniors applied and were accepted to colleges. Oh, and the total amount of monies received from merit-based scholarships for all of them totals $4.7 million. Well done. Kelsey Hill and Dr. James Benson, our college placement and career counseling office, you change lives. Our first president, Dr. William Hatcher, said, the best way to prepare for life is with a Bible-based education. He said you can learn a great deal about life on the playing fields, working with others, as well as in the classroom. He was right. For 125 years, body, mind, and spirit, thank God we can do this at a private Christian school in Virginia in the United States of America. And thank you for sending your son to FUMA. I hope you appreciate a little bit of this context today before these magnificent men. I'd like to recognize a few folks. Our board chair, Ms. Paige Pruitt. Our board of trustees and alumni board members who are in the audience. The Fluvanna County Sheriff, Eric Hess. Our law enforcement and our EMS workers. Thank you for what you do. God bless you and keep you safe. And Senator Mark Warner sent his regrets, and Alexis Bowles Fryer, his outreach representative, is with us today. Thank you, ma'am, for coming. Now, I'd like to welcome our chaplain, Chaplain Jameson, to the podium to deliver our invocation.
Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. You have given it to us and asked us to rejoice and be glad in it. And so we come to this place to rejoice and be glad in each of these young men who are present here and their families who have stood behind them for 18 long years. We thank you for all the faculty and staff and the tireless ways that they have invested in these young men to prepare them for what comes next. We thank you for giving them a calling, for handcrafting them in the womb, giving them a unique set of skills and a purpose for being here in life. Father, as we go forward in this ceremony, we do all to your honor and glory. It is in Christ's most holy name we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Chaplain Jameson. Good morning, everyone. My name is Colonel Mike Ode, and I'm blessed to serve as the Academic Dean here at the Academy. It has truly been an honor to work with each of the young men who sits before me today, many of whom I had the honor to teach, either as upper schoolers or when I served as a seventh grade teacher. At this time, I will proceed with the recognition of this year's honor graduates. To achieve this recognition, a cadet must complete a minimum of 10 academic terms at the Academy between grades 9 and 12 and meet the following criteria. Complete his senior year with a cumulative GPA of 3.5 or higher. Maintain a conduct level of commendable or exemplary during his junior year and a conduct level of exemplary during his senior year. And have received no honor violations or made no admissions of guilt to an honor violation during his academic tenure at the Academy. This year we have 9 honor graduates who we will recognize in alphabetical order. As you can see, each of these young men was awarded his honor graduate medal at last night's senior awards ceremony. Young men, when I call your name, please stand, face the crowd, and remain standing until all 9 names have been recognized. Audience, I would ask that you hold your applause until all 9 names have been recognized. Our first honor graduate in the class of 2023 is Cadet Reese D'Alessandro. Reese is the son of Ben and Karen D'Alessandro of Charlottesville, Virginia. Reese attended the Academy in grades 9, 10, and 12 and has a cumulative GPA of 4.186. He will be attending the U.S. Merchant Marine Academy in the fall, where he will be a member of the basketball team. Grant DeMauro. Grant is the son of Tina and John DeMauro of Fort Union, Virginia. Grant has been in attendance at the Academy since the 7th grade and has a cumulative GPA of 4.194 and served as this year's battalion commander. Grant will be attending the United States Military Academy at West Point in the fall. Well, June. I think you report in June. Don't get it messed up, Grant. Usman Dieng. Usman is the son of Elhaji Dieng and Nafi Njai of Germantown, Maryland. Usman has been in attendance at the Academy since the 7th grade and has a cumulative GPA of 4.417. Usman will be attending Vanderbilt University this fall. Justin Frazier. Justin is the son of Scott and Stacy Frazier of Palmyra, Virginia. He has been in attendance at the Academy since the 7th grade and has a cumulative GPA of 4.081. Justin will be attending Hampton-Sydney College this fall. Wesley Lay. Wesley is the son of Angela Hensley and Mick Lay of Stafford, Virginia. He has been in attendance at the Academy since the 8th grade and has a cumulative GPA of 3.981. Wesley plans to attend Tennessee Tech in the fall. Jackson Freitas. Jackson is the son of Jessica Neal and Michael Freitas of Charlottesville, Virginia. He has been in attendance at the Academy since the 9th grade and has a cumulative GPA of 4.781. Jackson will be attending the College of William and Mary in the fall. Isaac Rivera. Isaac is the son of George and Amber Rivera of Palmyra, Virginia. He has been in attendance at the Academy since the 10th grade and has a cumulative GPA of 3.5. Isaac plans to return to FUMA next fall as a member of the postgraduate football team. Matthew Vinso. Matthew is the son of Joseph and Libby Vinso of Stafford, Virginia. He has been in attendance at the Academy since the 11th grade and has a cumulative GPA of 3.734. Matthew will be attending Virginia Commonwealth University in the fall. Lucas Yates. Lucas is the son of Joe and Heidi Yates of Goochland, Virginia. He has been in attendance at the Academy since the 7th grade and has a cumulative GPA of 4.107. Lucas will be attending the U.S. Merchant Marine Academy in the fall. Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for our 2023 Honor Guard. Gentlemen, you may now be seated. At this time, I will now recognize the Academy salutatorian and valedictorian for the class of 2023. Gentlemen, when I call your name, please stand and face the crowd. We will begin with our salutatorian. This year's salutatorian is Cadet Usman Diang. Usman is the son of El-Haji Diang and Nafi Njai of Germantown, Maryland. He has been in attendance at the Academy since the seventh grade and completed his high school career with a cumulative GPA of 4.417. Usman will be attending Vanderbilt University this fall. Usman, what a fantastic speech at last night's award ceremony. It has been a pleasure to get to know you for these last 6 years, and I can still remember calling your name that first day of roll in seventh grade back in 2017. I look forward to hearing about all the big things you're going to accomplish at Vanderbilt and beyond. Congratulations. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a round of applause for our salutatorian. At this time, it is now my pleasure to recognize the valedictorian for the class of 2023. This year's valedictorian is Cadet Jackson Paredes. We can go ahead and complete that round. Jackson is the son of Jessica Neal and Michael Paredes of Charlottesville, Virginia. He has been in attendance at the Academy since the ninth grade, arriving in the fall of 2019 as the trustee scholarship recipient. Jackson finished his academic tenure at FUMA with a 4.781 GPA and will be attending the College of William & Mary in the fall, where he will participate in the St. Andrews William & Mary joint degree program. Jackson, I know I speak for many when I say that we are proud of all that you've accomplished here at FUMA over the last 4 years. When I sat in on your interview for the trustee scholarship 5 years ago with Colonel Coggins, Dr. Benson, I believe Colonel Gizak was there and myself, I had a feeling someone would be saying this to you one day, the podium is now yours and I hope you have your speech.
Well, here we are, boys. I'd like to begin by praying to God that nothing in the next several minutes comes along to prove me wrong when I say, congratulations, we're Fork Union Military Academy graduates. We made it. We are here and have earned this honor. I think it is first necessary to thank everyone responsible for supporting us along the way. So to every parent, teacher, TAC, coach, family member, friend, and mentor who helped to bring this moment to us on this day, thank you. Bless you all, and know we are forever grateful for what you have done for us. You know, I pretty much drove a lot of my buddies here crazy back in the day by constantly keeping track of how many days we had left in each school year. To me, it was comforting. To them, a lot of them, torturous. My particular journey here at Fork Union was 1,384 days long. And now we've come to the final day, the conclusion of a long journey, one in which a lot has happened in the world. The global pandemic that hit in the middle of our freshman year was probably the most impactful for us, but we've had several major wars, remarkable new technologies, and genuinely life-changing adventures. 3 weeks into my freshman year, I wrote an email to my mother, hi mom, that included lines such as, I've already cried buckets today, I'm treated like dirt, Fork Union isn't what I thought it would be, and everything has been disappointing. And listen, If any of you in this class told me you hadn't experienced similar thoughts, I'd call you a liar. This academy is challenging, and at some point breaks all of us, makes us lay on our barracks bunk, crying, unable to sleep from exhaustion, homesickness, and misery. Yet, I see nearly 50 of you sitting before me, and many more alumni in the audience who have made it through, stuck with it, and persevered, who earned this day, and we are better for it. So as we savor this precious moment together, I wish to offer you the most valuable piece of wisdom I carry with me. My advice as to how we should go out into the world to live our lives as men, created from the lessons learned from my mistakes, challenges, and experiences here. To begin, PUMA by design has kept us busy in our time here. In the classroom, the drill field, the athletic courts, our clubs and extracurriculars, this kept us out of trouble, mostly, occupied our minds and bodies, and gave us a sense of achievement and accomplishment. As you begin your new journey, continue to find things to do. Seek honorable work that is meaningful to you, and give your best to it every day. Explore fulfilling hobbies to keep your mind and body healthy and serve your community. With that formula, success will follow. Secondly, our time at PUMA has also taught us about the sincere love of brotherhood through the bonds we have formed. I bet most of you would say the people and each other are your favorite things about PUMA. And at the same time, being away from our families and loved ones, we developed a new appreciation for how much we love and care for them. So again, carry that deep and genuine love in your heart as we make this transition. Honor your parents and elders always. Work at remaining connected to your siblings and close friends. Cherish your spouse eventually, and take good care of your children eventually. Love your neighbors and treat them well. Finally, at PUMA, we have focused heavily on our spiritual life. We prayed together and for each other. For many of us, those prayers sustained and strengthened us as we worked toward this very day. Now that we are here, this is just the beginning of our spiritual life. So I ask that you pray. Pray hard, pray daily, pray in the good times and in the bad times. Be thankful always for what you have. Seek a spiritual mentor and find a faith community you feel comfortable in. Know that your faith is a solid rock to always seek rest and rejuvenation. Friends, life will always throw curveballs along the way to us. Just look at the COVID-19 pandemic I mentioned, coming out of nowhere in our freshman year, suddenly affecting so many things in our lives. At the same time, we have to be prepared for serendipity. Tiny little things in our lives may blossom into extraordinary changes that pay dividends for us. I'm about to spend 2 of the next 4 years of my life in the United Kingdom, and on Monday, I'll attend a youth summit with NATO, all a chain reaction inspired by my getting interested in international relations from our commencement speaker's class. It was his idea to talk about serendipity in this, by the way. So, but seriously, it's up to ourselves to steel ourselves for unforeseen adversity. We have to keep a clear eye to seize upon unexpected opportunities and fortunes and never let the latter become the former. If we can do that, well, we have a very good chance of leaving this world better than we found it. We each have our own unique tools to make that happen. But we have bonds uniting us all that are needed now more than ever in today's world, shared by all of us. Dedication, determination, discipline, and leadership. PUMA prepared us for the future, and the future is now. So let's begin, men.
Thank you for a wonderful speech, Jackson, although the beginning of that I had to wonder if maybe there's some sort of shenanigans planned for the middle of the ceremony here. So, no, just kidding. Great job. Wonderful, wonderful speech. At this time, the Fuma Band will play a rendition of Fuma Men Are We, the lyrics to which are on the insert in your program. Fuma Men Are We was written by Colonel Rob Feathers, a longtime member of the Fuma staff and faculty, and a member of the Fuma class of 1979. Petty Officer Warren, band, show is now yours. Petty Officer Warren, members of the band, thank you. For those of you who don't know, for many years we had an Army band that actually came in and played at graduation for us. And for the last 2 years, we've actually had our own band playing our own songs here at graduation. So let's give them one more round of applause. It's now my pleasure to welcome the Academy's Board Chair, Ms. Paige Lester Pruitt, to the podium, where she will introduce this year's commencement speaker, Colonel Bill Hitchcock. Ms. Pruitt is currently self-employed practicing law. Her father, Edsel H. Jack Lester, was a member of the Fuma class of 1951. She was elected to the Fuma Board of Trustees as an associate trustee in 1998 and as a trustee in 1999. Since then, she has served as the chair of the Endowment and Investment Subcommittees and has also served as a member of the Executive Committee. Now, Ms. Pruitt is serving as chair of the board. Ms. Pruitt, it is now my pleasure to turn the podium over to you.
Good morning. Let me begin by conveying my personal note of congratulations to each member of the class of 2023 and their family and friends who have done so much to support them as each one achieves this important milestone. It is my honor today to introduce the commencement speaker for Fork Union Military Academy's 125th commencement exercises. For a man as distinguished as Bill Hitchcock, I could give an introduction that would make it sound like he'd been here all 125 years. But I will try to be more succinct because he's only been associated with FUMA for 49 out of the 125 years. But as each of you graduates today, I will note to you that one of the timeless challenges you face is determining from whom you will not only seek advice, but take advice and emulate. Bill Hitchcock is such a man. Bill was born in Chicago and attended and played football at Lake Forest College. After college, he enlisted in the United States Marines from 1961 to 64 and attended the rank of first lieutenant. Following his time in the Marines, he obtained his master's degree in history from the University of Arizona in 1967 and began his PhD. While he did not complete his dissertation before leaving Arizona, he did find his lovely wife, Kathy, who fortunately led him back to Virginia, where in 1974, he accepted an opening at Fork Union Military Academy to teach history and coach football. He only expected to stay 1 year. Fortunately, for Fork Union Military Academy and countless young men, it turned out differently. In his early years with the academy, then Captain Hitchcock taught geography to freshmen and eventually moved on to teaching government to juniors and seniors. He was instrumental in developing the AP and dual enrollment programs at Fork Union and eventually rose through the ranks, achieving the FUMA rank of colonel. Through the years, he held other roles, such as headmaster of the middle school, advisor to honor council, and coach of many sports. But he always returned to his first love, the classroom, where he would continue to do and teach until his retirement this spring. Colonel Hitchcock is a recipient of the Ford Foundation Teacher of the Year Award and also received a study grant from the National Endowment for the Humanities. While that outside recognition is gratifying, more importantly, he has earned the respect and admiration of the cadets, his peers, and others in the FUMA family, as he has impacted the lives of so many here at the Academy over the course of the last 49 years. Personally, one of my favorite things about Colonel Hitchcock is that he is the epitome of civility with competent debate. Of late, Colonel Hitchcock has made note of the fact that he served in the Marines, was hired by a Marine in 1974, and now officially retires from service under another Marine. That speaks a lot to the person he is, the values he holds, and his reasons for serving the Academy with love and gratitude for 49 years. As he winds his way to full retirement, he may finally have time to finish up that dissertation, but he will certainly have more time to spend with his family, particularly his grandchildren. But first, he will share some wisdom with all of us, but particularly with each of you. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to welcome Colonel Bill Hitchcock to the podium to deliver the Fork Union Military Academy commencement address for the class of 2023.
Thank you, Mrs. Pruitt. Mrs. Pruitt, Colonel Coggins, distinguished guests, faculty and staff, friends and family members, we are here to honor the graduates of Fork Union Military Academy class of 2023. Congratulations, men, you made it. The hard work is done, and now it's time to celebrate and enjoy the moment. You've earned it, you deserve it. Before I continue, however, I would like to thank your parents for entrusting your lives into our care. Their sacrifices on your behalf attest to their love for you and their faith in Fork Union Military Academy in preparing you for the next level of your journey through life. Thank you, Mom. Thank you, Dad. Thank you, Grandma, and thank you, Grandpa. You are forever in our hearts. Next, I would like to thank the alumni, the Board of Trustees, and the Friends of the Academy for recognizing the need to make a FUMA education available to as many qualified students as possible and providing the necessary resources to do so. Thank you for your generosity. We are forever in your debt. To me, there is no greater privilege than standing here sharing this moment with you. From today's perspective, I can look back on my past, reflecting on the significance of your achievement as you look forward to your future, anticipating the rewards of a job well done.
I am the result of my past. You are the hope of your future. I know where I've been, while you have an idea where you are going. For we all see tomorrow through a glass darkly. Perhaps my experiences then might be of some value in helping you navigate the fog that covers your future. You're about to invest in the most precious possession you will ever own, your reputation. Never forget that. The decisions you make today will impact the person you will be tomorrow. Accept the awesome responsibility to that man you seek to become, so that 70 years from now, you can reflect with gratitude on that kid in whom you entrusted your life. And you have the courage to change that which you can change, the peace to accept with serenity that which you cannot change, and the wisdom to know the difference. Point of order. We are all in this together, and no one has a monopoly on the truth. Now, what exactly does it mean to be a FUMA graduate? It means you make your bed every morning and shine your shoes every night. It means you shave and shower daily and got a haircut every 2 weeks. It means you set aside weeknights for homework and weekends for rest and relaxation. It means you attended chapel twice a week and church every Sunday. It means you know that God is love, and when we sacrifice self-love for the love of others, we're in God's embrace. It means that you know that self-discipline and love are the keys to leadership. It means you possess the skills necessary for success at the next level. That's what it means to be a FUMA graduate. Strangers who don't know you, but know FUMA, will expect you to live up to those standards, if not surpass them. FUMA's reputation is in your hands. For me, that is an awesome responsibility. Whenever someone asks me if I ever served in the military, I say yes. Then they say, what branch? And I answer, the U.S. Marines. And automatically, they react as if they want to buy me a cup of coffee. Why? They don't know me. They don't know who I am, but they know the reputation of the Corps, and I benefit from those who built that reputation in their youth. It reminds me that although I was on active duty for only 3 years in an era of peace, I have a responsibility to uphold that reputation for the benefit of others who serve. In my youth, my goals high. I had an offer to teach at the University of Southern California when I completed my dissertation. All I had to do was complete the dissertation. Well, as you can see, I never reached that goal. Serendipity. Instead, I ended up at a place that eventually exceeded all my expectations, where I learned the meaning of friendship, collegiality, and brotherhood. A place dedicated to guiding boys in making the difficult transition to becoming men. A place where role models are essential in the educational process. A place where I met Sergeant Major Glenn Sidwell, a man who sets a standard of behavior for all to emulate. When things get tough and I'm faced with a difficult decision, I ask, what would the Sergeant Major do? He knows that leadership involves making tough decisions. And I know that he would never jeopardize his reputation in compromising the easy way, what he has to do for the easy way, what he would like to do. Tough love and self-discipline. It ain't easy being a leader, but who said FUMA was easy? Moreover, everyone needs a drinking buddy. And Glenn, we found a great coffee shop, a safe spot where we can go to relax, unload, and better feeling than to walk into your favorite watering hole and get a big hug and a shout out from the serving lady behind the counter to the admiring glances of your friends. Never forget that strangers who know FUMA, but not you, will judge you by the way you measure up to FUMA. And people who know you live by an honor code. We neither lie, cheat, or steal, nor tolerate those who do. Or in the words of poor Richard, Benjamin Franklin's alter ego, if you lie with dogs, you're gonna get fleas. We assume responsibility for each other by taking responsibility for ourselves. So when you're out on your own, make sure you find a good coffee shop, and may I add, a Sunday school class. Read a newspaper daily, take plenty of notes, always remember those who brought you to the dance, and marry someone smarter than you. Love you, Kathy. As you journey through life, and may the Lord hold you in the palm of his hand forever. Drink big, work hard, enjoy the ride, and who knows? Serendipity. Have fun, but keep the faith. Thank you. God bless.
Much for the wisdom you shared today, Academy, to share a special announcement with you all. It is my distinct honor and pleasure to announce today, in recognition of a lifetime of service to our Academy, which has benefited generations of young men, the creation of the William Hitchcock Chair of Excellence for Social Studies. Once fully funded, this endowed chair will stand in perpetuity to support the position of our Social Studies Department Chairperson and to create an enduring legacy in appreciation of the tireless work of Colonel Hitchcock, so as to ensure his impact on Fork Union Military Academy is recognized and continued for generations to come.
Now for the moment everybody's been waiting for. Here in the next few seconds, we will begin the presentation of diplomas. Audience, while I know each of you is very proud of your individual graduate, I kindly ask that you hold your applause until all names have begun the presentation of diplomas.
Laquan Shamar Almond. Gene Sterling Anderson, Lewis University. Jordan Blaine Anderson, FUMA postgraduate. Jeremiah Nathaniel Baston, The Citadel. George Fortunato Boitano, University of Rhode Island. Charles Derek Marcellus Campbell, The Citadel. James John Clark, New York University. Kendall Nigel Cord, U.S. Naval Academy Prep School. Jace Matthew Corbett, Bluefield University. Mauricio Benedetto Di Alessandro, U.S. Merchant Marine Academy. Min Phu Dao, Penn State Kensington Campus. Dalton Emerson Davis, The Citadel. Grant Christopher DeMauro, United States Military Academy, West Point. Usman Momar Dieng, Vanderbilt University. Jackson Jeffrey Edwards, University of Lynchburg. Justin Timothy Frazier, Hampton Sydney College. Alessandro Gomin Gaudio, National Aviation Academy. Lance Tyler Gowans, Mary Baldwin College. Sean Michael Hall, Northern Virginia Community College. Chase Isaiah Hill. Zhu Hang Hung, Portland State University. Jai Edward Johnson, Norfolk State University. Damari James Joseph, Central Connecticut State University. Ashton Kimari King, Virginia State University. Dominic Robert Lancey, Bridgewater College. Wesley Tate Lay, Tennessee Tech University. Maddox Paul Lee, Christopher Newport University. Michael Austin Linher, James Madison University. Thomas Michael Manganello, Sacred Heart University. Michael Tinashe Marinduri, James Madison University. Trenton Bernard Maxwell, The Citadel. Jack Kellen McCall, The Citadel. Charles Lawrence Moore, James Madison University. Matthew Donnell Moore, Lynchburg University. Jackson Monroe Freitas, The College of William and Mary. Isaac Asalino Rivera, FUMA postgraduate. James Hunter Robinson, Virginia Military Institute. Alibek Sarambayev, Norwich University. Jacob Shane Seymour, United States Navy. Ahmad Bevan Shaw, Morehouse University. Peter Raymond Signorino, Virginia Community College. T- Tugs, Sotobator, University of Massachusetts, Boston. Copeland, Mars, Spearman, Sydney College. Ethan Thomas Strove. Matthew David Vinzo, Virginia Commonwealth University. Lucas Dalton Yates, U.S. Merchant Marine Academy.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's not time to throw your hats. No, 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 no. I don't get to do that. That's Colonel Coggins that gets to do that. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, you're a Fork Union Military Class Academy class of 2023. I think this is the best build-up we've had in a long time. Here shortly, Chaplain Jameson will deliver our benediction. Following the benediction, Colonel Coggins will confer the diplomas, officially declare the 2022-2023 academic session closed, and that, gentlemen, is when you may toss your covers. We're almost there.
Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we are so grateful for each and every one of these young men and the hard work that they have poured into this place. Lord, we are incredibly grateful to you that you have given them a calling and a purpose in life, and we just ask for your guidance as they go out from this place, enjoy themselves over the summer, and then start the hard journey of adulthood. We are also grateful for every parent here. We ask that you would help them to enjoy this moment and that your peace would descend upon them during this upcoming transition. Lord, we love you. And we thank you. It's in Christ's most holy name we pray. Amen.
It's time. This is it. On your feet. If you're able, ladies and gentlemen, please rise. Gentlemen, based on the authority entrusted in me by the Virginia Council for Private Education on behalf of the Board of Trustees, I declare you graduates of Fork Union Military Academies in Christ. Gentlemen, you may toss your covers.
Trophies. Some are loyal soldiers while these other thorns are rosy. And if you never know who you can trust, then trust me, you'll be lonely. We'll be right back.
tonight is my appeal.